guaranteed you are going to get a network configuration task on the RHCSA exam. And everybody's got opinions on what the best way to complete a given task in Red Hat Linux is. But if your only thought is, I just want to pass this f***ing exam, then this is the video for you. This is the kind of task that we're locking down, where we need to set an IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, DNS server, all applied to a specific interface, and you need to change the hostname. And we're doing that only with the nmtui tool. And, hey, get out of here! Look, we're only using nmtui for one reason. It is easy to remember. It's one command, not like three. And you can accomplish everything you need to do in an easy graphic interface so you can pass your exam. Are you ready? Because here we go! All right, so let's knock this out. Remember, you need to either be root or execute a command as root using sudo when you call the nmtui command, which will open up a display like you're seeing here. We're going to edit our connection. Make sure that you choose from the easy menu which one of these interfaces is the one that you're supposed to edit. ETH0 is the one that we're working with. That's going to take you to this screen. And good news, you can ignore most of what you're seeing on this page. Just go down to IPv4 configuration. We don't want this to be set up automatically. We want to change it manually to what you can see above my head here. Click manual. And then highlight and click show. And here is where you start just simply copying and pasting. We're supposed to put our IPv4 address, which I'm going to hit add and paste that in there. Now you'll look and see that while there are fields for most of the things that are above my head here, there's nothing for subnet masks. That is what needs to go after your IPv4 address. So 255.255.255.0 is insider notation /24, which is what I pretty much guarantee is what you'll be asked to do on the exam. After that, it's fill in the blank. For gateway, we'll just go ahead, grab this here, paste that there. For DNS server, click add, grab that there, and paste that there. And that's it. Couple copy and pastes. And we're done. Just go on down to the bottom, make sure that you select OK, and then we'll go back. Now, you're not finished yet, all right? And here's where all the NMCLI fanboys and girls would be like, well, I could just reset and activate it with a command. Yeah, we can do that with NMTUI as well, all right? That if we go to activate a connection, and then for ETH0, we're going to deactivate it, reactivate it, and then we're good to go. All right, and then we'll go back because there's still one more thing that we have to do. We have to change our hostname. Then you click on system hostname. I would always recommend that you copy and paste any of these values because it would be really silly to lose points just because you spelled something wrong or you put in a typo. So there you can see our hostname has changed. We'll go ahead and we'll quit on out of that. Now, if you're like me and every other elder millennial I know, your anxiety medication is never too far away. So I want to show you how you can guarantee that what we just did is actually going to persist and solve this task. Fortunately, it's real easy to check. Just run that IP space A command and then just do the old stare and compare. Do the IP addresses line up? Does everything look the way that it should? And if that looks good to you, then you can follow that up with a hostname CTL command. And there you can see our hostnames match as well. If you follow these directions, you'll conquer your Red Hat exam. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. God, so stupid.